Shavua Tov, a Gut Avoch, and welcome to our program. Emiyat Hashem Sunday night is the first candle of Chanukah. There is a great connection between Chanukah and Moshiach. As a matter of fact, there are like 5-6 connections between Chanukah and Moshiach. We will return to that in a moment, and we will give you time to contemplate and to figure out how many connections you can come to concerning Chanukah and Moshiach. But first, our customary story. Our customary story is connected with Chanukah. It was the first time we put up the menorah on Fifth Avenue, and it was done with great circumstance because it was the first time a large menorah on Fifth Avenue and so on. Rabbi Chodakov called me. And you knew when the call comes from him, it's generally something that comes from the Rebbe. We knew a klal that if you called Rabbi Chodakov and you asked him for a question, you asked him a question, and he answered, Lav Dafket came from the Rebbe. It's the answer that he answered. Nevertheless, he covered himself. He later would tell the Rebbe what he answered, because more than once he would call back next day and he would say, concerning what you have asked me, and I have said this and this, but there's something we can think about. Maybe we should do it differently. Just the opposite of what he said yesterday. Why? Because he went into the Rebbe and the Rebbe told him what the Rebbe told him. However, we also knew that if he initiates a call, then you got to be very, very careful. That can very well come from the Rebbe himself. Here, he not only initiated the call, he asked me to come into his room. I came to his room. And he asks, so who is lighting the menorah? And I told him, we had the mayor of that time, Mayor Abraham Beam. We had the senator, Senator Javits, if you remember. We had the Attorney General of the State of New York, Louis Lefkowitz, who was the Attorney General for many, many years. And then he asked the question, "On was is mit Bob Abrams, El Zinteich? Is Bob Abrams also lighting?" I kind of told him that so far on the schedule, we were looking for people who hold a statewide office or a citywide office. Bob Abrams, at that time, was the president of the Borough of the Bronx. And we don't know yet. He didn't pay attention too much to what I said. And he just answered. He just said, Bob Abrams, Dafzinden. And we already understood. No argument. And he said, Bob Abrams, Dafzinden, that's how it's going to be. We called Bob Abrams. He was the president of the Borough of the Bronx. And Bob Abrams led the menorah. A few years later, Bob Abrams ran, and he was elected as the Attorney General of the State of New York. And he came to light the menorah as the Attorney General for the State of New York. After that, there were some Jews, I must say chutzpahdika Jews, and you know, chutzpah by us, we don't have to go and borrow from someone else. There were some Jews who wrote letters to the Rebbe, and in their opinion, they said they don't know why the Rebbe is allowing Chanukah menorahs on public property. It is just, there should be a separation of church and state. Therefore, there should not be a Chanukah menorah on public property. And the ones who wrote it, Apo Yidlach, that had a little bit of chutzpah. And in one of the letters, the Rebbe answered them. The Rebbe answered them. How can you say that this is a separation of church and state, and therefore you cannot light a Chanukah menorah on public property, when the Attorney General of the State of New York, he is the custodian of all matters of justice in the State of New York, and he himself lit the menorah? Concerned, and he mentioned Robert Abrams. So then we understood that when Rabbi Chodakov called and he said, Bob Abrams, Sinteich, that was because the Rebbe asked him, What about Bob Abrams said to them so years before that there's going to be a need for everyone that Robert Abrams should light the menorah because he's going to be the Attorney General of the state of New York and he'll lead the menorah for many years. Rabbi say, concerning the connection between Hanukkah and Moshiach, you probably had a chance to think about it. And there are many connections. The first connection, perhaps, is Hanukkah is light. The light, the light of the menorah. That's the first thing. The light of the menorah is connected with Eirei Shel Moshiach. The eternal light of Moshiach. The light that we are hoping for. The light that we are hoping for that's going to be burning and lighting and illuminating for eternity is the light of Moshiach, Eirei Shel Moshiach. The lights of the Hanukkah menorah are connected, light and light, air and air. The Eireis of the Hanukkah menorah was Eirei Shel Moshiach. That's one connection. Another connection. Moshiach is called Moshiach, that's his name. Moshiach. What does Moshiach mean? Moshiach means anointed. Anointed. B'shemen kodshi meshachtiv. Motzosi David Avdi. I found David Avdi, my servant David. B'shemen kodshi meshachtiv. With my holy oil I anointed him. So with what was Moshiach anointed? With oil. And why is he called Moshiach? Because he was anointed with oil. Anointed with oil. And we know the pasuk in Shmuel. Almighty God said to Shmuel Hanovi, Malei karen necho shemen, fill up your keren. It was like a horn that you would fill up with oil. V'lechel Yishai beis halachmi, and go to Yishai to beis lechem, ki ra'isi bevonov li melech. Because I saw one of his children is going to be melech. A reference to David Melech Yisrael. And David Melech Yisrael was anointed by whom? By Shmuel. With what? With oil. So Moshiach is anointed with oil, and oil is the Yontav of Hanukkah. Another connection. Hanukkah is 8 days. Now why 8 days? You're going to say, of course, it took 8 days until they found new oil. But there's also a deeper connection. Why did it take 8 days? Because they had to take 8 days. 8 days the Rebbe brings from the Rashbo. The Rashbo said that they are Shivas Yemei HaHekef, the 7 days of the cycle. The Sunday, Yem Rishen, Yem Sheni, Yem Shlishi, we know in Chumash, 7 days. Shabbos is the 7th day. And then there is the 8th day. The 8th day the Rashbo called Shemer HaHekef, the guardian of the cycle, one that's higher than the 8 days. Moshiach, he has a connection with the number 8. Kinei Shel Moshiach, the harp of Moshiach had 8 strings and so on. Moshiach has a connection with the 8 days. And this is why it says in Sforim of Kabbalah that a child, the bris is at the eighth day, because it's a connection with Moshiach. That each child is a spark of Moshiach. As Isaac to Menachem Chernobyl, each neshome is a spark of the neshome of Moshiach. So that's another connection. Now, shemen, oil itself, has a connection with Moshiach. Why? Because what is Moshiach going to teach us? Rozin de Eiraisa, the secrets of the Torah. And as Rashi says in the second pasuk of Shir HaShirim, Seit ta'ameho umistal tzvinisehu. Seit ta'ameho, the secret of her reasons and the mysticism of her teaching, of her treasures. That's what Mashiach is going to teach us. Now, within Seder HaTorah, there are 2 kinds. One is called Yayin and one is called Shemen. Shemen is also called Rozin de'Eraisa. However, Yayin is called the Rozin, the deeper secrets. And why is that? The Shemen, the wine, is within the grape. The oil is within the olive. But there's a big difference. To get the wine out of the grape is not very difficult. You squeeze a little bit, you squeeze the grape, and then you get the juice. The juice is yayin, bilipliagofen. Even if you give it to a child can squeeze. If you squeeze the olive, you're not gonna get oil. You need a special process to get the oil out of the olive. So therefore, the process of getting the wine out of the grape is a much easier one. This is why those in the Eraisa, the secrets of Tehila, are likened to wine, to yayin. Those in the secrets of secrets are likened to oil. So therefore, Moshiach is going to teach us those in the very secrets, the secrets of secrets. So therefore, there are many, many, and maybe there are more. There are many, many connections between Moshiach and Chanukah. And mainly, Rabbi say, we want Mashiach to come. By now, it's not. The Rebbe made Mashiach popular. There were days where people were afraid to talk about Mashiach. Baruch Hashem, today Mashiach is popular. There are songs about Mashiach by everybody. Everyone is talking about Mashiach. So therefore, because the world is ready for Mashiach, the world wants Mashiach. With all the troubles that we're going through from Milon a year ago, and we didn't forget that, constant sodas, Rachmanut Lislan, the Jewish people should see nachas, and it's time we should see nachas, and we want to see real nachas, eternal nachas, Lono L'chol Yisrael. So everybody wants Mashiach to come. And what is Mashiach? The light of Mashiach. So we want that the candles of Hanukkah that we are going to start all over the world, Jews Achinu B'nei Yisrael all over the world, are going to start lighting Emir Tashem Sunday night, Emir Tashem, they should usher in Elei Shel Moshiach, the light of Moshiach, which we see Moshiach here in this world, B'peil Mamash. It is also interesting, Rabbi Say, that the Rebbe changed the face of Hanukkah. Face of Hanukkah for generations was a Jew, lights a menorah in his house. Sometimes he puts it out if it's possible, and so on. The Rebbe took this Yom Tov of Hanukkah and he made it nachlas of Kol of Klal Yisroel. Years ago, when there was a public menorah, there was against a whole big chidush. It's not a chidush anymore. There are 15,000 public Hanukkah menorahs that the Rebbe shluchim, the Rebbe's children all over the world, are lighting. So the Rebbe made Hanukkah, and it wasn't that easy. There were many people who had complaints with all kinds of excuses. Timeim sheinim shunim. But the Rebbe kept going and kept encouraging. There should be public lighting Hanukkah menorahs, so that a Jew all over the world goes on the street and he sees a menorah, it reminds him that he is Jewish. And Baruch Hashem, 15,000, that's what I was told, and it's probably more by now, all over the world, that the Rebbe lit up the world with the light of Hanukkah. I want to share with you a very interesting Ramban. The Rebbe brings that. It's a Ramban on Behaleischo es Haneris. It has to do with candles. And we read it on Hanukkah. Behaleischo es Haneris. Almighty God says to Moshe Rabbeinu, and he should say, tell Aaron that he should light the menorah. And we all know that there is a medrash, and Rashi brings it behaleischo saneres lefishik shero Aaron Chanukas anesim. When Aaron saw the Chanukas anesim, the scene brought, it's also called Chanukas because it means dedication and rededication. Chol shos daite. His mind grew faint. Why? Shelohoye imoyim b'chanuko, that he was not part of the Chanuko, of the Chanukas HaMizbeach. Lehuve leishifte, Reuven, Shimon, and so on, but not Shevet Levi. Amalei HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So Almighty God said to Aaron, Chayecho, I swear by your life, Shelcho gdelo mishelohem, Shato madlik umeiti v'saneris, that you are preparing and lighting the neilis in the menorah. The Ramban brings this, and he brings what Rashi says, and he asks that, first of all, What was the big thing that Alan Akin didn't bring Chanukah, was not participating, but he did so many other things. He brings korbanos that nobody brings. He brings k'teiros. So, and the Ramban answers that Almighty God said to Aaron, I have something greater for you. It has to do with lighting a menorah. Now, which menorah is he talking now? He says, I have something greater than even lighting the menorah that you are lighting now. Because now you're lighting the menorah in Mishkan, and the Mishkan is not going to last forever. Then your children are going to light the menorah in Beis HaMikdash. Unfortunately, the Beis HaMikdash is not going to last forever. The first Beis HaMikdash lasted 400 years. Second Beis HaMikdash lasted 410 years. But then it was destroyed. But Almighty God said to Aaron, I'm going to give you something that's going to go on forever. And you know what? That your grandchildren, the Chashminoim, are going to light the menorah, and then there's going to be the mitzvah that every Jew lights a menorah because of your grandchildren. The menorah of Hanukkah. That's what the Ramban said. That this is a reference that Almighty God said to Aaron, you are going to light the menorah of Hanukkah. Ve'enan betelin le'elom. And those candles will never be abolished. So the menorah that every Jew lights now because of Hanukkah, because of the children of Chashminoim, the children of Aaron HaKohen, everybody lights the menorah now. And that is the connection to Neris Hanukkah. That's what the Ramban says till the beginning of the passage of Baal Yitzchok. Now Rabbi Yisrael, כשנכנסו יוונים להיכל, the Gemara in Shabbos, when the Yavonim came into the Heichel, timu kol ha-shmanim shebeheichel, they contaminated all the shmanim. And after that, they couldn't find any oil, and then they found one jar of oil that lasted only, that should have lasted for one day, it lasted for 8 days, the Nes of Chanukah. Let's analyze this. כשנכנסו יוונים להיכל, יוונים are terrorists. Terrorists come into the Beis HaMikdash. What is the first thing the terrorist is going to do when he's going to come into the Beis HaMikdash? It's simple. The terrorist, he's a terrorist, when he comes into the Beis HaMikdash, he will break, he will destroy whatever he can. Kishenichnesu Yevonim leHeichel, when the Yevonim came into Heichel, what do they do? Timu kol ha-shmanim shebeHeichel. They contaminated the shmanim. This is a very funny terrorist. We know a terrorist with a gun, Yimach Shmom V'Zichrom, that break, that destroy. Moreover, the terrorist saw oil. What should he have done with the oil? He's a terrorist. He should have taken the oil, arguably, that's what terrorists would do. And he would smash it to the ground and he would break the jar and he would spill the oil. That's what a terrorist would do. What did this terrorist do? Timu kol ha-shmanim shebeheichol. He contaminated all the shmanim. The Rebbe asks, what's this? This is not a terrorist that we know on. This is a different kind of terrorist. A spiritual kind of terrorist. Timu kol ha-shmanim shebeheichol. This is the first thing he wanted to do. What is the answer? This was a spiritual terrorist. This is not a physical terrorist, which is even worse. A spiritual terrorist, why? He didn't go after the Jewish body, he went after the Jewish soul. Timu kol ha-shmanim shebeheichel. What do they want to do? They're going to take all the oil in the heichel, and they are going to contaminate it, and then they are going, the Chashminoim are going to light the menorah with the contaminated oil. So what they're going to do? They're going to bring in contaminated light into the Beis HaMikdash. They will bring in the Hellenist philosophy, the philosophy, Rachmanu Litzlan, that we should have no part of. They're going to bring that into the Jewish home. They're going to bring in the Hellenist culture into the Jewish home. That's what they wanted. They didn't look only to harm the Jewish body. They were looking to harm the Jewish soul. And if they could have, and the Rebbe talk about it, we say lehashkicham teira secho. They didn't care if you would learn Teira. They were very smart people, lecheira. And Taylor is a very deep philosophy, and it's a lot of give and take on this end, on the other end. They like that kind of sharpness. It sharpened their wicked mind. So they didn't mind if they learned Taylor. However, lehashkichom Taylor secha, they didn't want the nation of Taylor, that a Jew should be connected with the nation of Taylor. That the Friedrich Rebbe says. And the Rebbe says even more. They wanted to make us forget the chukim letzeinecho of your will. L'chele, it could have been enough if we would say, l'hashkicham tirosecho, l'avilo mechukecho. We should stay away from the chukim. What does it say? Chukei letzeinecho. Chukim of what you want. And the Rebbe explains, what is a chok? You can say sometimes a chok, it's culture. You know, sometimes you say culture, it's holy. Nobody argues, this is the Jewish culture. But it's more, this is not, a chok is not just Jewish culture. A chok is chukei letzeinecho. It's what Almighty God wants. We understand, we don't understand, doesn't make any difference. We do it for one reason. Even those that we, the things that we can understand, even kibbutz, we do it for one reason. We do it for one reason, because this is what Almighty God wants. And therefore, we don't question, because azei vil der Rebbe, it's your will, Almighty God, it's our command and our pleasure. And that's exactly what they didn't want, that there is another super being, Almighty God, to whom we answer, and not to them, and not to their culture. And that's what troubled them. And this was the fight, and that we were victorious. That the Jew is observing Taylor mitzvah for its mitzvahs for one reason, because of the nesein ha-Taylor. Not just because Taylor is something very deep, and of course it did. It is, and it doesn't need our okay for that. It's because there's a nesein ha-Taylor. There's a giver of the Taylor, and we are making a connection with Almighty God Himself. And when we're doing a mitzvah, this is what you want. And the B'nai Shalom, it doesn't make any difference to us whether we understand and we don't understand. That's not important at all. The connection that the Jew has is nasa v'nishmo. First we're going to do, and then we are going to understand. And that is exactly what the Yevonim, the Hellenists, didn't want. So therefore, we waged the war, and we were victorious and victorious until this very, very single day. And we make a beloche. She also needs him love. He's saying, Almighty God, who made many miracles in the past, but we want a great miracle. By Yomim Mohem Bizman Hazeh. And not only do we want a great miracle, Rabbi Say, we want the miracle of miracles. We want the greatest miracle. The greatest miracle of all time, that these lights of the Menorah that we light all over the world should usher in the eternal lights of Moshiach. Gesundheit und Freilichheit. And as the Rebbe tells us, we're the last generation of Golus and the first generation of Geulah. And may these lights of Chanukah usher in the great light of Moshiach. Und Gesundheit und Freilichheit. Uba Golo didan, uva Simcha, uva Tuv Levov, uva Teva Nila ve'anigle, uva Mata me'asol atfochim, uva Chesed, uva Lachamim, v'tekev, umiyad, mamish. But please don't go away. You see behind? Limud Achona Yud Aleph Nisan Tov Shin Pei Beis. This year is a special year. It's 120 years of the birthday of our Rebbe. And the way to prepare for Yud Aleph Nisan, the Rebbe says that his kashrus is by learning his Torah. If you go in on this site, yudalefnisan120.com, you will see all the Torahs of the Torah of the Rebbe, 250 volumes of the Torah of the Rebbe. Until now, 20% or more were distributed. Please be part of it for our own sake, so that we prepare for the great day of Yud Aleph Nisan. We prepare the way the Rebbe wants, we should prepare, as the Rebbe says in Asiche concerning 120 years of the birthday of the Rebbe Nishmo Satan, that we prepare through Tele, it's Mifza Tele. And by preparing the way the Rebbe wants, we are sure, Im Yotz Hashem, that come Yud Aleph Nisan, we will celebrate Yud Aleph Nisan together with the Baal HaSimcha, on the Baal Yemoledes, with the Rebbe himself, in Yerushalayim Yerakedesh, Gesundheit und Freilichkeit, Tekev umiyad mamish, a Freilich Chanukah to everyone.